In this video, I'll be discussing molecular level pictures or molecular level views of different types of substances in solution. So far in Chem 1A, we've talked about how to differentiate between molecular and ionic compounds. And in this video, we're going to further differentiate these by considering molecular compounds that are either soluble or insoluble in water, and ionic compounds that are soluble, slightly soluble, or insoluble, also in water. Now, when we're talking about solubility, we could think about a lot of different types of solvents, but in this class specifically, for this learning objective, we're going to focus on solubility in water. So for soluble ionic compounds, these are compounds that will fully dissociate into individual ions. Dissociation is a word that you'll hear a lot in terms of solubility, and what that means is that they will break apart into individual ions. So here are three different pictures, and based on what you know so far, which of these pictures would best represent aqueous potassium chloride, assuming the substance is soluble in water? The correct answer here is B. Now, the reason why B represents aqueous potassium chloride is because you can notice that the positively charged potassium cations and the negatively charged chlorine anions have separated from one another. And you'll notice they're evenly dispersed with these different water molecules, as shown in solution. Now, the difference between B and C is that this picture for C is actually representing an insoluble ionic compound. So let's talk about what that means. So insoluble ionic compounds remain together as a solid lattice even after they're added to water. So here's a picture before adding an insoluble ionic compound to water. And after adding, guess what? It still remains as a ionic lattice. It hasn't dissociated into ions, or if it has, it hasn't dissociated very much. Now, like everything in chemistry, there is some gray area, and this is in the case of slightly soluble ionic compounds. These are compounds that partially dissociate or break up into ions when added to water. Now, molecular compounds are somewhat different. You'll remember that molecular compounds are composed of two or more nonmetals, and they behave differently based on the fact that they are held together by covalent bonds instead of electrostatic attractions. So for insoluble molecular compounds, these remain together as a cluster of molecules when added to water. Now, here's an example of water and oil. If we zoom in at this water and oil interface, the top layer is our oil molecules. These are molecular compounds composed of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. And these molecular compounds stay together as a cluster. And the water molecules also stay together as a cluster. So what would an example of a soluble molecular compound be? Can you think of any? A soluble molecular compound is the compound that will separate into its individual molecules when added to water. One common example of this is sugar. Now, this is a pretty complex picture, but let's break it down. So the smaller molecules that you see kind of around the edge here, these are water molecules, and the larger molecules are sugar molecules or sucrose. The big cluster here on the left-hand side represents sucrose in a sugar cube or a sugar crystal. When sugar is added to water, the individual sucrose molecules break off of the sugar cube. You'll notice that when they break off, they stay together as sucrose molecules. They don't break up into individual atoms, and this is really important. So unlike ionic compounds that break into individual ions, when molecular compounds dissolve in water, they stay together. And the reason for that is that covalent bonds tend to be stronger than electrostatic attraction in ionic compounds. One note here is that you'll notice this picture on the right looks pretty complicated because of all of the different molecules that are shown. And so sometimes you'll notice in molecular level pictures that water molecules will be omitted for clarity. And what that means is that you're just looking at the either soluble or insoluble compound, whether ionic or molecular, but without the water molecules kind of getting clouded and getting in the way. So with this learning objective, it's really important to be able to represent the behavior of these different types of compounds, either ionic or molecular, when added to water. So here's a bonus practice that you can do on your own. Identify ionic and molecular compounds that are either soluble or insoluble in water. Then, for each compound you identify, draw a molecular level picture before that compound is added to water and after. You can omit water molecules for clarity so that you don't have to draw them in, but just show what's happening to either the ions in the ionic compound or the molecules in the molecular compound in your picture. Good luck!